welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Lisa, also known as ladolcelisa, and I'm happy to be back with you guys. I had a little bit of a break because I wasn't feeling my best, but I guess who is in this day and age, right? So being away actually had me baking a lot, because what else do you do when you're at home with nothing to do? I just keep cooking and baking, and I was inspired to share this recipe with you guys. With few ingredients, minimal effort, no special utensils or tools required, you can literally make bread in minutes. Now this is a no yeast bread recipe. So usually yeast gives bread that delicious smell and taste and of course texture, but this recipe is so unique because in place of the yeast, we just use baking soda and we make an instant bread. It's incredible. There's no special kneading required. There's no wait time required. You don't have to let things rise. You don't have to play with yeast. It's so simple. So let me show you how I make this. Want to do when making this recipe is preheating your oven, because that honestly takes me at least 20 minutes, I would say. So I always get that preheated to 425 degrees Fahrenheit. I love to preheat my oven right away because this bread needs to go into the oven immediately. So I don't even start to make this bread until my oven is preheated. Right after I preheat my oven, what I work on then is the milk ingredient in this recipe. This milk, typically an Irish soda bread would call for buttermilk, but I don't have buttermilk on hand, and I don't know about you guys, but it's not something I ever really buy. So I feel like substitutions is so important here. So the easiest thing to do is to use milk. You want a full fat milk, and if you tend to use skim or 1%, I would say add a little bit of cream to that. So maybe do like a cup and a half of the milk and at least half a cup of cream, or just 10%, 5%, whatever, just to make the milk a little bit thicker. I happen to have 3% milk on hand because that is all I could find at the grocery store, and that actually works perfect here. So to the 2 cups of milk, what I do before I even start to make the bread, because this needs about 15 minutes to come together, I add 2 tablespoons of an acidity. So you can add 2 tablespoons of lemon juice, or you can add 2 tablespoons of white vinegar. You need an acidity because this milk needs that acid in order to work with the baking soda in this recipe. Once I have the acid, the 2 tablespoons of acid in my milk — this milk was cold, it was in the fridge — I just leave it out for about 15 minutes just so that everything gets all blended together. The milk comes a little bit chunky, but that's actually what we want. It's perfect in this recipe. Now, why is it important to have the oven preheated? Because as soon as we add the milk to the baking soda, this bread basically starts to work right away. So you really just want to stir it, form it, and place it in the oven. It is honestly that easy. What I have here is 4 cups of flour. Now, of course, if you guys don't have regular all-purpose flour, you can substitute this with whole wheat flour, or even bread flour, or you can do a combination of flours. It is honestly your choice here. Because this is hard times right now, guys, feel free to use some substitutions. I have 4 cups of flour right in here. Now, to the 4 cups of flour, what I added is 1.5 teaspoons of salt. And most importantly, I also added 1.5 teaspoons of baking soda. Baking soda is basically what is going to give this bread its rise, as opposed to the yeast. So once you add the salt and baking soda to the flour, just give it a quick whisk. What you should do is get a nice pan on the side with parchment paper so that you're ready to go. I also have a little bit of additional flour that I'm going to be using just for the quick knead that this bread needs to come together. So with the flour aside and the pan aside with your parchment paper, we can now make this bread, and it takes seconds to come together. So what I'm going to do is take our milk mixture that we made — we essentially made our own homemade buttermilk — and I'm going to pour this into the flour, salt, and baking soda mixture. I'm going to give this a stir, and it only needs a few stirs to come together. And once it is nice and chunky and you can no longer stir with ease, we are going to place this on a lightly floured surface, and we are going to knead this no more than about 5 to 10 times. And as you knead it, you're going to form it into a ball and press this down and place it on this parchment paper. And we're going to press it down lightly because we want this to be about 1.5 to 2 inches high, no more than that. So press it down, form it into a nice little loaf. And then the final steps is we're going to just cut across right into it, and now immediately place this into the oven. So this bread has basically a double bake time. Essentially, you're going to be baking it for the first time at 425 for 20 minutes, and then without taking the bread out of the oven, you're going to cancel that and bake it for 350 for an additional 20 minutes. So it has a 40-minute bake time with, of course, two temperatures. I find that this works best for this bread. You need the nice high temperature at first, and then you need a lower temperature just to continue cooking this bread. The important thing is that right when it comes out of the oven, we are going to place this onto a wire rack if you have one, and we are not going to cut into this bread for 25 to 30 minutes at least. It will still be warm by that time, but you really don't want to touch this bread. You need to let it do its thing and just cool off a little bit before cutting into it. So I'll see you guys back here in a bit, and we're going to try this delicious bread. So I'm back after the 40 minutes total baking time and the 25 to 30 minutes resting time. We can now cut open this bread, which I have done with a nice serrated knife. It's perfect to cut open a piece of bread without damaging it too much. This bread is so delicious. It's still warm. It honestly smells so good. It smells a little bit more oaty in a way than regular yeast bread. It's just so delicious, and it looks exactly the same as a typical yeasted bread. It has the nice firm crust and the soft inside. So toasted becomes a little bit more firm, and of course, the bread as it is has a nice spongy texture. It's truly phenomenal. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try a little bit. And since I, of course, have a sweet tooth, you guys probably already know, I'm gonna have some with a little bit of butter and jam. Oh, so good. And this is, of course, toasted. So I have just enough for a delicious bite for myself. I cannot wait. Again, this is the bread, but toasted with a little bit of butter and jam. I love the seedless raspberry jam. It's so good. So I can't wait to eat it. I love this bread. But as you can see, the inside is nice and soft and tender, and the outside is crunchy. It has a really nice crust on this bread. So delicious. It's almost shocking how easy this was, guys. I really do hope you give this recipe a try. And if you do, please feel free to let me know in the comments down below or even tag me on Instagram. I love when you guys post my recipes in your stories. And remember, I can only see them if your profile is open. So otherwise, feel free to send me a private message and show me how this bread is coming out. I'm so curious to know. Now, of course, this bread is very versatile. I did a completely plain loaf. You can also make a savory version with herbs and such. And of course, if you're, like I said, if you're just planning on making a sweet version, a little bit of raisins in this bread would also be delicious. Feel free, you can use this however you'd like. I really like to just make a plain version because sometimes I feel like having it with something sweet like Nutella on top would be delicious, or sometimes I feel like having the savory as like a sandwich, or even just to dip some nice butter or olive oil in it. So good. So guys, this bread is fantastic. I am so happy to finally share this recipe with you. I've been making this for years, and honestly, now that we are stuck home in quarantine, I feel like everyone just wants to do something, and there's nothing more satisfying than making bread, and the fact that you'll probably already have all these ingredients at home is just perfect because I have anxiety now going to the store, and I'm sure you guys feel the same way. So please, guys, let me know how this bread comes out for you. For me, it is a hit every time. Like I said, please check out my blog post on ladolcelisa.com for the complete recipe and a few more photos. And of course, tips. I can help you with substitution or with adding things to make this sweet or savory. So I just want to say thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye! Bye, guys. Happy baking.